Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Let's start a journey with Nilay. Today we are going to learn how to do homology modeling practically. In our last video, which was the first part of homology modeling, in this video we saw the theory of homology modeling and what are the steps. Today we will learn how to do it practically. As you know, we will do homology modeling for the unknown sequence to predict the 3D structure. So at first we need a sequence, that is a protein sequence or sequence alignment, that is our sequence of a protein. You can get this sequence from so many data bank, protein data bank. You can get this from the RSB protein data bank. You can download this for sequence as a FASTA format. So what can we do and how to build a 3D structure of this sequence? Today we are going to learn this. At first you should go to the search engine of the Google. Just search here, switch model. Look at that. And you search here Swiss modeling, and you may get swissmodel.xpsi.org. That is the official website of the Swiss model. Yes, in this online web server, we can predict the 3D structure of our unknown sequence. Just go to the start modeling. Okay, that is here to paste your target sequence. That means we have a target sequence, and now we will copy this from here and we'll paste that here. Look at that. That is a sequence which is showing here as a colorful sequence. And you, if you want, you can click here and you can put your name of your project, and if you want you may write here your email. You will get the result in the email, but that's optional. So here are two options. One is search for templates, other is build model. If you want to build model, you if you want to click this, then you can get the 3D structure. But I will suggest you first not to click here. I will suggest you to go through this process, search for a templates. Look at that. This space, the templates is analyzing here, and that is called our unknown sequence of the protein. After waiting for some minute, maybe we'll get so many templates here. I said to go through this template process, not to go through the model building process, because if you go through this model building process in our previous base, you will get a 3D structure here. But that actually this server is an online server, so there are some algorithm here. If you don't select any templates which is the best, then if you click to the model, then you will get a model, but that is depends on this server's algorithm, not like your choice what is the best for you and what is the best sequence. You don't get this. You will get the sequence through the algorithm, but if we go through this process as a template, then we may get a best result. So wait for some moment. Yes, you can see here are some templates showing in there. So many templates is here, but which is for us, which will be the chosenable for us? Look at that. These are the templates, and here you can see the 3D structure or 3D view. Look at that. If you click here, you can get a new. Look at that. You can get a new structure. But what will our chosenable structure templates here? First of all, look at that. That is the name of the. That's a PDB ID, and that's the protein name. Look at this. That's a coverage. What is this coverage? Actually, the coverage is called a query coverage. That means how much of our query has been covered in this entire sequence. Here you can see that is good, and what you will select, you can see the identity. The important thing is identity. Look at that. That is 94.74. That is 94.78. You can see the several one, which is best. Look at that. That is the identity, which is 100%. Of course, we'll choose this one. If you may get two template, look at that. That is also 100, and we may get two about the identity, which means the highly identical. We need a highly identical, but here one is 100, another is here. That is also yes. Three is here as 100, but which we should select two. Solve this problem or to know about this question, we need to know the GMQE. What is the GMQE? That means Global Model Quality Estimation. What is this? Actually, it estimates the quality of the model which is closer to one. That means it's a good model. So if you get the GMQE of the 100, that is 100 is 93, and you may get, that is also if you get another one, that's called, yeah, that is 93 and 89. So obviously you I said here, if you get the GMQE closer to the one, okay, so that's also 93, and another one is, that is also 93. You can select this one, no problem. Okay, look at that. That is showing here a 3D structure of this. Now what can we do? Now we have to click in the build model. Now as we select the as we select this one only, and you can see the 3D structure of this and of this template. Okay, just click here as a build model. Look at that. That is our result, and yeah, that is the 2D structure which we are searching for. And yes, that is a oligostate and homotrimer. Okay, see, two of the score is here. One is the GMQ, which we have selected before in the template selection part, and the another is Q-min score. What is this Q-min score? Actually, you have built a model. Is it good or low quality? How good the model is, it's depends on this Q-min score. If you get this like a thumbs up, that means you built a model which is good enough. Here you can see the graph of look at that. That is a model, a star mark. If you get this star mark here within this blackish or ash area instead of hair white areas. That means your model is good enough. Okay, if you want to download this 3D model for further analysis, you can go here, and if you want a PDB format, then click here to download the tertiary structure as a PDB format. Okay, thank you very much. Like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.